Hello, welcome to Do It Yourself with Wayne. Our channel is all about teaching you how to do things yourself to save you money. And today we're in our camper and we got a problem with lighting. This is our pantry for our camper. And as you can see, it's really dark in there. Well, we're going to install a tape light. I'm going to install it right back in here, all the way up and down, so that it will illuminate our pantry better. Because right now, with the lights on, you can see the stuff that's right in the front, but you can't see back in the back. So that's what we're going to fix today. To get started, I purchased this tape light from one of the big box hardware stores. It's 8 feet long. I'll put a picture of this up in the corner so you can see a little bit better if you're interested. But these do come in different lengths, and they just plug into a regular outlet and you run your tape light wherever you want to. Now, I did another video a while back in our kitchen in our house, and I put a link to that down in the bottom because we installed one of these tape lights, and this is what the tape looks like. It's very flexible. It goes around corners, it bends. It's real easy to work with. But the one that we installed in our kitchen under the kitchen counter cabinets to illuminate the cabinet in our kitchen. We did that some time back and it has worked very, very well, and we're really pleased with it. So we're going to install this one here in our camper, and I think it'll really help to illuminate this pantry so we can see better. Now, unfortunately, I can't show you a lot of what I'm doing because there's just not a good angle for the camera. But what I've done is I went back here in this corner of each of these shelves and I drilled a hole. I used a 3/8 inch drill bit, and that gives me a hole large enough to run the tape light up through it. Now, run the tape light from the bottom all the way up to the top, and this is the part that I cut off. On these tape lights, there are places where you can cut it and it doesn't hurt anything. You just have to be careful that you cut it in the correct place. But this is some of what I had left over. And so anyway, we did that. We run it from the bottom all the way up to the top. I drilled an extra hole down at the very bottom of the shelf, at the bottom shelf, so I can run the end of the cable through and in under the cabinets, because I'm going to plug it in the bathroom. So we'll have one of those little blocks that you plug into the wall for power for small things. That'll be plugged in a bathroom, but that'll be in there. And another thing I want to point out, if I can get it working, I'm going to do a second video, because what I want to do is put a switch in here so that when I open the door, the light comes on automatically. And I feel very confident that I can make that work. And if I do, there'll be another second video about how I did that. So stay tuned for that. And also, these tape lights operate off 12 volts. And I have 12 volt supply in my camper. If you have a camper, you understand about 12 volts as compared to the 110 volt for your normal house. And at times you don't have the 110 volts, but you always seem to have the 12 volts. I'm also going to try and modify my tape light to run off the 12 volts instead of wall outlet, the 110 volts AC in the wall. So stay around. If you subscribe to our channel, you're a lot more likely to be able to find that video. But I'm hoping to be able to make those two modifications so that the light will work anytime, even if the camper is not plugged in. And when I open the door, it'll come on automatically. So right now it is working. Give me just a minute, I'll plug it in and we'll show you what it looks like. Now there you have it, the light is turned on. You can see how much better illuminated the pantry is. I put before and after pictures up in the top. And this tape light does have a switch that lets you adjust how bright it is. And I'll turn it down now, you can see it dimming. You can turn it all the way off with that switch, or you can turn it all the way up as bright as you want to this level, obviously. And I really like the fact that the amount of light you get from the tape light is adjustable. I think that's a really nice feature as well. So anyway, that's our install for this tape light in the pantry of our camper. If you find this interesting, I'd really appreciate it if you would share it with your friends and click like and all those things that you can do in, on YouTube. And again, if you subscribe to our channel, it makes it easier for you to find our other videos, our past as well as our future. including the one that I hope to be doing about installing a switch to make this work when the door opens, as well as make it operate off the 12 volts instead of the normal house current 110 volts AC. So just like to say thank you for visiting. Do it yourself with Wayne, and we hope you have a great day.